have to say the achievement of us as well. Of course we are proud. You know, what do you have to say? Because this is the Japanese generous taxpayers' money. And they should know that because of our money, that country really changed, really developed. And also they are thanking us. You know? So there's still, most of my friends, they still think, wow, there's a big war, nothing has been. Of course we have a problem, I know. But the achievement also there. So you should know it, and also media should say it. From now on, I'm giving you a tour of Afghanistan. Okay?
Yeah.
Okay. So, then, okay. I think we should use this one. So, the theme is, of course, as you can see, this one, but there's a sense, I have been told the time is a short, so I will go just a quick one. Okay. This is Afghanistan, you know, one of the biggest assets. Is fortunately the young generation. They are very cheerful, very alert, very keen to study. Almost from, as you saw, from 5 to 24 years. It's the biggest asset, yeah. So, and thanks to God, and of course, the time of regime of Taliban, only around 700,000, only almost boys could go to school. But now we have more than 10 million that enroll in school, and almost more than 35% are girls. You know, because girls, as you know, they were struck of the study. So we have ministers, ambassadors, pilots, police, teachers, media, TV, singer, worker, in all walk of life, ladies and girls, they're very active now. Next is population. The population will still honestly depend on dependent place and sometimes security situation, a lot of things. They're not exact figure, but almost now stands to about 33 million to 34. But this year, it's just showing 38 million, but it's up to next year. So by 2020, but now it's the standard 34 million, so population. And the country is 1.7. A time larger than Japan. So this also the almost same Java as some statistics of some urban population, which just have in mind. But today I want to concentrate on other main issues, especially climate, which is coming from now on. Now this is agricultural formation. Arable land, forest area. Afghanistan is also, as you can see, an agriculture country. So this amount of the land is very sufficient for our agriculture. So almost we are going to turn for the depend on crops and agriculture products. We are going very soon to be over, you know, become the hand to the export level. And the rice and wheat, bread, is the main food of Afghanistan. And Afghanistan is almost 100, more than 120 kind of rice we have. The fruits also everywhere, as we have dry fruits over there, you can see later. Almost around the year, any season, if you go, more than 5, 6, or even 7 type of fruits. Very delicious, very fresh, you can find. That's why dry fruits also. With almost a vegetable. So one of the main points of Afghanistan is that all time, even there's a big war or very bad situation, almost food is there because it's an agricultural country. And also very similar to Japan if you go to the northern near Hokkaido, I'm coming to the south with Okinawa. So the more you go to the north, it's becoming more cold. Heavy snow, and coming to the south, where especially here, Jalalabad, is the warm. So sometimes is the winter capital. And a very unique country. Maybe 1 or 2 hours, if you go by car, everything different. The face, language, clothes, food, you know, the weather. So in one country, you can enjoy at the same time so many, you know, different cultures, like that you can see different, you know, countries. And also the main difference with Japan is Afghanistan dry, very hot in summer, but very dry, but very cold in winter, depending on the place. Japan is a little, you know, where that's the main difference. Which today is very main point of Botanical Gardens, three Afghanistan, thanks to God, in the past 19 years, depend on sector, we really achieve, our achievement is really big. Unfortunately, media is not saying that, media is just, you know, focusing on war, or Taliban, or Daesh, or IS, or killing bones, that doesn't. Of course, we have problems, difficulty, but a lot of achievement as well we have. So, especially the trees, every year we have Nowruz, which is equal to that, it's New Year of Afghanistan, for example, the 21st of March. More than million trees, we every, you know, every year we are planting. And also, this is a traditional, you know, a kind of, you know, habit that everyone should, you know, plant trees. So that's also, and also thanks to your great efforts, as Miss and Lebron, which can also add to that, you know. So thanks a lot. You know, so for those reasons, the Afghanistan is really getting, you know, year by year, those difficulties, but we are getting, you know, better in that aspect. And especially this Jalalabadi and the Mirab, which the late Dr. Nakamura, which we just, you know, had a silent of 1 minute for him, he did also a great project, great job. As you know, he turned the desert to Russia, you know, more than a million people are, you know, benefiting. Afghanistan had those risks, you know, potential a lot. I'm coming later, you know, with, you know, a big mountain we have, all from here on is close to more than 7,000 meters, you know, mountain, all from Pamir, all the coming to Hindu Kush. These mountains going to Iran, even to Turkey, you know. So a lot of mountain and a lot of water. So that's why very green area, very, you know, we have potential for to have an agriculture, you know, plants and trees and also for those great potential we have. So, and also, so these are the main points for this. So this just from here, this also. And now is the main part for the, you know, countries, natural resources, as is written here. So natural resources, as you know, Afghanistan is really almost untouched from whatever you think, which is coming from the, for example, out of 17 rare metal of the world, we have 14 in Afghanistan. And almost all natural resources, including the, those, you know, rare metal, is two main points. First is quality, great, and quantity. Quantity is really this mountain, mountain, all of them is and almost untouched, as I said, for example, the copper mine is the second largest in the world. It's close to Kabul here, we call it Mr. Ainak in the Logar province, second in the world, you know. So, and also Hajigak is the iron ore mine, which is in Bamiyan. This also is, as they say, if you is almost close to 200 years. Is enough for all world to use it. So like that, you know, those are very, you know, the natural resources is really great, you know, abundant natural resources. Also, and also this, Miss Ainak has a very good, you know, one that close to Miss Ainak, you know, mine, we have now a lot of the archaeological that, you know, from 2,500 years ago, this time. So a lot of, you know, things every day they are, you know, digging out and it's coming. So I will give you that picture later, it's coming. So now the Afghanistan government really is, you know, was thinking to develop the economy, those corporate loans that were just, you know, make importance of the culture side, which Afghanistan decided to, you know, to promote the cultural side, because it's very, very, you know, rare things. And from almost 2,500 years, you know, it's very important for the country's, you know, future as well. And also precious stone as well. We have this really great, as you can see, lapis lazuli. This, of course, again, especially Badakhshan mountain, we have from emerald, ruby, gold, silver, whatever it is. Always I'm saying, you know, if we are going together to for digging it, once you go through it, you become returnable as a millionaire, you know, so it's so, such a figure, you know, all a lot of, you know, money we have. And I just love to say that, you know, even from the time of, you know, ancient Egypt, Cleopatra also has used it. And also in Japan, almost 1,200 years ago, a bed came from Afghanistan as a Sushuri temple in Nara. So I have seen it there, and it's for sure from Afghanistan, because that is really two countries, Afghanistan and Chile, really there. So Chile, I don't think 1,200 was coming, there's no way, but from Afghanistan. So those are natural resources also, very, you know, a lot of precious stone is there, and also major water resources comes later. So Afghanistan is very, you know, very, very rich in natural resources as well. And also next is the infrastructure. Infrastructure, so all it is of Afghanistan, you know, we had a great balance, I mean, before the war started, as before 1978, or especially Soviet invasion 1979. So the country was really well balanced. The well balanced with the countries. We had unique, you know, relation with the West and East from both sides. And once our support, getting help and a lot of infrastructure. For example, we have many provinces for the Helmand, from the US, United States was helping. And Nangarhar province, Soviet Union. Pakistan province was helping by Germany, Nuristan by France, like that. Even the roads also were like that. You know, all of us are dividing with all, you know, and with the well balance, you know. Unfortunately, all this, you know, collapsed, you know, after those, you know, years. So we are once again rebuilding it now, you know. It takes time, but once again, I'm telling you that depending on sector, Afghanistan achieved a lot of personality. That's why we are really thankful to the international community, especially Japanese, you know, help and assistance. You know, for example, the road, only in Taliban time, 160 kilometers was paved away. Now also close to 20,000 kilometers. It's crazy, all ours. We have airports, we have roads, we have, you know, schools, we have, though we have difficulty, but why I'm saying this, but it's very important. Always, sorry to say, I'm a kind of, fight with media. I say you have to say the achievement of us as well. Of course we are proud. You know, what do you have to say? Because this is the Japanese generous taxpayers' money. And they should know that because of our money, that country, you know, really changed, really developed. And also they are thanking us, you know. So there's still, most of my friends, they still think, wow, there's a big war, nothing has been. Of course we have problem, I know. But the achievement also there. So you should know it, and also media should say it. So, and also, next. This connecting road, as I mentioned, this is just a small, you know, all there's a lot of, so many other connections, you know. So, next, let's come to the water. So now, main and very important issue of our country now is, and also the world, actually, problem is water. As you know, day by day, the world is getting warm, and global warming, you know, which I put a nickname, not really global warming, that's global warming actually. So water is a very important issue for Afghanistan as well. And what we need is we're talking with China and the Japan government to teach us or train us for that water management. Afghanistan, as I mentioned to you, we have a lot of snow, a lot of mountains, very heavy snow. Just 10 days ago I was in Kabul, you know, there was also much snow, very cold. So we have, thanks to God, that. But unfortunately, most of our water is going, you know, before we use it in a good way to building dam, you know, electricity, agriculture. There's only a small amount we can use it now. So we are want to have, you know, in the future to have more, you know, those. Also, Afghanistan, most places, snow is not the mountains there, the scenery view is very similar to Japan, like Nagano, like Gifu. So there's also a lot of good dam, you know, we can build. So next is this is the water, you know, main river of Afghanistan. Here, five main source from all this Hindu Hindu Kush and the main Pamir mountain, as I mentioned to you. The amount is very big, but the northern part is 880 million. Out of 113 billion cubic meter, we can use only 880. Or the next Darya, Amu Darya, which is coming all from, is from northern, like this, you know, coming all the way to finally to Uzbekistan. So this also, out of 48 billion cubic meter, we can use only 120. Or again, another river, also Hariro, this is coming all the way to, from here in Iraq, is here, and going to Turkmenistan. The next is the Helmand, which is also a very big river, with a big amount of water. Eventually is going to Sistan of Iran. And also this river Kabul and eventually Kunar, all together is going to Pakistan. So this water is really, we are very rich in that amount, but well, only needs to be more managed, you know, so that's very, I mean the environment of Afghanistan, which Afghanistan has just repeated, I'm saying, nature is really very, you know, supportive of Afghanistan, more friend of the nature is really good. Four seasons we have, by the way, spring, summer, autumn, and winter, so people can enjoy all clothes, different food, different environment. And so. So that's also very, again, you know, very, you know, we are thanks to that. And also, again, the river I mentioned to you, while the general about here, as Dr. Nakamura Sensei, his name is really, so he was like an angel to me, not really believe in human. That's why his name is many times we have to say that he made great canals here and from Angela. But actually, what we have, of course, just the way how to make, bring it, you know, that was the, his, you know, idea, initiative, which he, you know, made this really green, you know, okay. So, and the next thing, he also does current program for, program and project for the water. As I mentioned to you, well, this is maybe it's a bit difficult for you to see, but just we are arranging a new way of mechanism, water managing, you know, project. We are just not now, of course, from years ago, but now more and more than we want to make. So, next is here is the casualty of water, casualty of climate. This is also very important. Unfortunately, the global adoption of the index climate of Afghanistan among the next very long law into the environment, Afghanistan has warmed more than 1.8 centigrade increase since 1950. But Ministry of Health, 3,000 people die each year of pollution. Unfortunately, especially Kabul, because of, you know, many reasons, sometimes, especially in the winter season, they burn the plastic or rubber or poor quality of coal, poor quality of gas or oil. So this produces very bad, you know, weather, which is really very, you know, pollution, very bad pollution we have, especially in the winter. Last week, as I mentioned, I was in Kabul, so it was really very bad situation. But that also government is going to, of course, not only Afghanistan, many other countries also are getting the same problem because of we are getting modern and everything. We have a lot of factories, a lot of things, you know, so we are struggling for that also as well. And for that reason, Afghanistan, you know, just entered into the Paris Agreement. You can see, of course, in April 2016, because of Paris, you know, you know very well, so environment of the world is very important. I don't want to talk more about this issues of political life, but you know we should be responsible for this because of for our next generation. Of course, we should think it's not only us, but the next generation. So, because of that, Afghanistan entered and we are supporting this agreement, so we will do our best. And Afghanistan, of course, regardless of whatever you have, you know, a question, I just, sorry, I made my, you know, just a short, just escape most of the places. Of course, we have a season of question and answer later. Of course, you're very free and very welcome to ask. to whatever you have in your question. Thank you so much. Thanks a lot for listening.